many shall run to and fro. Everybody knows that, stimulated by printing, there has been a greater development of knowledge along every line within the past century than during the preceding 59 centuries. Everybody knows that the telegraph, telephone, wireless, electric light, gas light, steam railroad, electric roads, machinery, conveniences, etc. of our day were all unknown a century ago. But although we know this to be true, it seems almost incomprehensible to the rising generation. These things have come so gradually that few realize that they are four gleams of the great thousand-year day of Messiah's kingdom, in which the curse will be fully removed, and instead the blessing, long promised of God, will be outpoured upon humanity abundantly. The Bible declares the coming glory of earth, when God shall make the place of his keep glorious, when the whole earth shall be a paradise of God. Our great scientists, who give no heed to the Bible, testify that present attainments are as nothing to what is just at hand. God describes our day in Daniel's prophecy, saying, in the time of the end of this age, many shall run to and fro, knowledge shall be increased, the wise shall understand, and there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation. Are we not in the midst of the running to and fro which this prophecy predicted? We must, therefore, be living today in the period designated the time of the end, the time in which this age will gradually close and the new age will gradually dawn with greater blessings. The first locomotive was built only 80 years ago. Now, in every land, multitudes are running to and fro whose grandfathers probably never traveled 50 miles from their birthplace. Surely no prophecies could be more accurately fulfilled than this one. Who but God could have known and foretold this marked peculiarity of our day? Jesus quoted a part of this prophecy.